I rise to support the railway budget and compliment the railway ministry and his ministry the contribution of pension fund which has been enhanced during 2001-2 has resulted in an addition of rupees 40 crores to the amount of the budget. It is really an excellent measure. 16 new lines have been introduced and 277 kilometers have been targeted for opening before March 2002. Further program for opening new lines in 2002-3 is totaling to 364 kilometers. Altogether, 16 new lines are going to be introduced. Madam, introducing land management is also a correct step. Track renewals for a distance of 300 kilometers have been introduced. Priority is given to railway electrification with a target of 3,500 kilometers in the 10th plan. New schemes for electrification of about 1500 route kilometers have been included in the budget. Exemption has been given altogether for several essential commodities from increase in freight rates. The Honorable Minister, the Prime Minister and the Deputy Chairman of the Planning Commission shall have to be complimented for their progressive policy deciding that the entire country should have one gauge. That is why the conversion of meter gauge to broad gauge has been introduced. This is a very correct measure. This will promote the backward areas and simultaneously provide employment to the poor and the needy. I would like to remark that the conversion of narrow gauge in the most backward area, that is Kolar district of Karnataka, has not been included. I do not know why the ministry is giving it a stepmotherly kind of treatment. Kolar is a backward and drought-prone area. The minister has taken measure to see that there is only one gauge throughout the country, that is the broad gauge. And yet he has neglected this particular narrow gauge line. I hope the ministry will kindly consider this aspect and see that this will be converted into broad gauge line. The rise in fare and freight charges is not high when compared to the previous budget. This budget has in fact taken care of the poor and the ordinary class passengers. There is criticism that the increase in fare and freight charges is steep and it is not in the interest of the rail users.